Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Subscribe to the channel. Follow us on Twitter, it's P Miller ENT. On our Instagram account, it's Prince Miller Entertainment. And we're also on our Facebook account, which is Prince Miller Entertainment. And also remember, guys, our videos are now available on our Instagram account. IGTV is Prince Miller Entertainment. Just go there, scroll our videos down. To now, it's audio thoughts, daily news, press play. Just have to go and watch our videos on our Instagram and Facebook accounts. And anyway, welcome to the daily news, breaking news. Today is the 18th of June 2020. As all know, the most trending topic yesterday was the strike of nurses and doctors at Parenyatwa Hospital, in a way that many people, yes. So later that day, the Ministry of Finance and Development, the office of Professor Mthuli Ncube actually issued a press release statement of saying Gucci, all the civil servants, they're gonna be getting $75 per month starting with June. Yeah, this is for like 3 months, and it got temporarily for like 3 months, and the pensioners are gonna be getting $25 every month again starting at this end of June, and also on top of that they're gonna be getting a 50% increase of their salaries. So which means that from whatever they were getting, they're gonna be getting a 50% increase on that, and on top of that they're gonna be getting $75 every civil servant, which means with mpurisa, dokutera, nurse, masoja are all four under civil service, under civil servants. And so which I think it was a very good gesture from the Ministry of Finance, but the problem now in the rate which is the Zimbabwe dollar, which is the bond against the US dollar. We all know the market reacts negatively with this whole announcement, in a way kuti kana chingwa chenge chicha maybe $60 now chamu $65, but the time for the time better end of the June, we're gonna see kuti chingwa chingcha tato double the price. So they need to sort out rate yoyo. In the end of the day, they need to eliminate black market. We've heard good Arab visit wakuti zoni that now are monitoring WhatsApp. Just be careful if you are into money exchanging business, if you are into money selling business on WhatsApp. These guys are now coming after you because they want to eliminate my black market. Until we eliminate black market, I think things gonna be good for us. But other questions people are asking is that, who owns black market? Black market Indian. Who owns the black market? Until we get those people who own a black market, then we'll be home free. Because it looks as if RBZ every time Pono Vramuromo, there's so much evidence that Mario when we wanna kupi Mario wanongo wabata ma new checks and stuff, so which means good RBZ maybe involved in black market. I don't know, guys. I'm just saying good Sony, it may be because nyoka huru hazvirumi. And so we need to they need to actually find out kuti black market you are key control and Dian, who owns black market. Until we can do that, we can actually have a stable situation. But at the moment, civil servants they'll be getting their increase starting end of June. And so talk to me in the comment section. Muyunoti mutaorone ni kana uri civil servant, you are in Zimbabwe, you just have to talk to me in the comment section. Muono kuti mutaoro kuti kuwezera matsira here kana kuti this is just a tip of an iceberg. And we need to talk in the comment section. We need more. We need more from this Adiga. So talk to me in the comment section. So attention. I was supposed to actually report this on a press play, but you know what, let me just report it now. You know, there's this lady called Shasha. You know, she's the first Zimbabwean to ever beg a BET nomination. She is actually she's actually based in SA, in South Africa. I remember Amapiano, and it's Amapiano, which is a new wave. You know, she is the leader at the moment. So she's the first Zimbabwean to be ever nominated for a BET award. So guys, I'm going to do Instagram page. BET awards. Atun Mufotero. Her name is Charmaine Chamiso Mampiro, aka Shasha Andidika. I know most of you actually didn't know her, Andidika, because we all know kuti once watanga career yako in a foreign country, kuti Zimbabwe is a supporter. Let's not need say as Zimbabweans, we always support our home ground talent, like kana wakatanga Zimbabwe, that's nice. But wakatanga kuimba uruku SA uruku Joburg, that's another story. So this lady, she's actually based in SA, and she's one of the leading girls, women who are actually doing a phenomenal job in terms of music in representing Zimbabwe. So she has been nominated for a BET award. So just go there and vote for her, Andika. Just go there and give her love. Her name is Shasha Andika. She's against some of the top artists from the UK, from France, from Nigeria also, you know. So it just shows what is when we are now getting recognized in our music, in our music industry, you know. Last time it was the Cook Off, which was on Netflix. Now it's a BET nomination. Maybe 2021 we'll be getting ourselves a Grammy award, you know, a nomination, you know. Everything is possible. So I just want to give shout out to all the people in Zimbabwe who are doing ads, and they can actually push up. So just go there on the BET award page on Instagram. She's a Zimbabwean sister, she needs our love. And let's make sure with the BET award, Raya ku Zimbabwe, Raya pa Harare, and it's Raya ku Mfakose, Raya ku Budiro, do that good as usual. Let's go out there and vote for her. She needs our love, she needs it more than ever, and it's girl. So guys, we're still talking about the Zimbabwe national issues. RBZ now, people in the shops are now allowed to put my prices in bonds and prices in US dollar. Which means this is the return of US dollar, and it can those are going to go nas. And it's, so don't be surprised to go into a shop and you find which sugar and get maybe 60 pound, then you have one there, $2.50 US. And it's, so those are those are ngopo, that all are multi currency now. It's now that whole situation, like a 2008 situation whereby if you are buying with a US dollar, it may be cheaper, but if you are buying bond, it would be a bit more expensive because muna anangaida US dollar. So I don't know kuti books but I think the camera say, but as far as the RBZ is concerned, it's now a multi-currency situation. So auctions of foreign currency will be used from Tuesday next week to set the official exchange rate. The Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe has announced. I don't know kuti varume vaviri varumbufunga ichi, but as far as I'm concerned, it's gonna be interesting coming days in terms of our economy, in terms of our foreign currency situation. You know, we're gonna keep an eye on what is happening in Zimbabwe. And so guys, thank you very much for listening. This is Daily News Breaking News. Let's go and vote out for Shasha Andidika. She's I'm a piano queen based in SA. She needs our vote on BET. Andidika, let's go and out there and vote. Moskwera mushe, marara mushe. Good morning. Thank you. Bless up.